Let's talk a little bit about social anxiety. Well, I used to be really bad, really shy, really introverted, and that's hard to believe for some people that I talk to nowadays because I am a lot better. And I went through a self journey to improve that. It took a conscious effort to do it, but it did start out pretty bad, and a lot of people out there that are introverted or just very shy and suffer from social anxiety might be able to relate to this. I remember being in grade school, and one of the thing was always being terrible and afraid at small talk or just chit-chatting, and I didn't really want to do it. I didn't have an interest per se, but kind of sometimes had an interest, but just didn't know what to say or how people would think about me. And I was very self-conscious about things, especially about my hair. If my hair was sticking up, I had a cowlick in the back and would sit in class all day with my hand there and be very worried about what people thought about me. And one thing that bothered me was always sitting when there was social times in class where people were talking and whatnot, and sitting just by myself or with my head down, sleeping or pretending to sleep, and people always coming up to me and saying, "Are you okay, Eddie? Are you okay? What's wrong? What's wrong, Eddie?" And really nothing was. Just didn't know how to talk to people. Didn't know what to talk about. Didn't know how to talk about it. So they were, "Are you upset? Do you hate us? So he doesn't want to associate with us." And that wasn't true at all. So as a young kid, I started gravitating towards friends that were more outward, more outgoing, more extroverted, and using them as my crutch. So using them as my icebreaker. So if I went to a school dance or a party, I could hang out with them the whole time, and I could talk to them or have them do the talking, and they would approach a group or get a group of people over to us, and I didn't have to do anything. I could just sit there and be that person's buddy. And I had a really good friend in the neighborhood that was like that, and unfortunately he passed away a few years ago, and I do miss him. And he was my first friend for that. It was so bad, I wouldn't even buy a candy bar at the store. I needed him with me. Would give him the money so he could go to the counter person and interact with the person behind the counter to get the candy bar, because I was too anxious to do so. I did not want to talk to that person in that store. So as I got older, I gravitated towards people like that and started being able to pick and choose the type of person that I could be friends with and be comfortable with, but they were also comfortable going out of that area to meet other friends as well. And I now have a friend that's actually kind of a cousin-in-law now, and he's pretty good at that, and he's taught me a lot. I've come a long way since then. And besides using him, started using other things to help me, where I would escape into things, but then also use those things to be more social. So like cars, working on cars became something where I can escape and do it by myself. I could be in the car all day and do what I love and not have to deal with anyone else. Then going to car shows, I can use what I learned working on my car, try and get known on the scene and get known for my knowledge so people can approach me to talk to me instead of me approaching them at car shows. It was still difficult, and I made a couple friends at car shows that I can gravitate towards, just hang out with them the whole car show, and people would come up, talk to them, and I would also be there, so I did not have to go out and introduce myself and whatnot. So same thing with YouTube. It became a way to get noticed for what I did and what I knew, and have people be able to talk to me without me having to approach them. Now it's a lot different. I do approach people in school and work. I'm oftentimes going out of my way to say hi to people that I want to say hi to. And it took years to get to that point. YouTube has helped me a great deal with that. People don't believe that I'm really shy. When they see my videos, they see how I talk in front of the camera. It's hard to believe that social anxiety is inside here, but it's just me and the camera right now. There's no one else in the room. It's very intimate. But to tell the truth, it still is a little bit there, because with other people in the house, I don't like raising my voice to have them hear me, to wonder, oh, what's this video about, and they want to come and see, or anything. That gets in my mind. I'm worried about that. Same thing if I'm at the office shooting a video, where I don't want to do it during hours where people are going to hear me talking in front of the camera. So that is still a problem. I'd rather do it myself, and I'd rather be very quiet about it. And I have to give my respect to people that are trying, and the respect to people that are the friends that I gravitated towards, the people that are more outgoing and more comfortable in different situations. It's very difficult to do that. And if you're like me, hopefully you have friends like that that you can find and that you can reach out to, and you know, stay comfortable for as long as you can. And if making videos or working on cars or electronics or finding a nice hobby helps you branch out a little bit more and get more outgoing, then great, then do that. Hopefully that helps. Let me know, you know, what are some of the things that you used as crutches? Were you the type of person that always fidgeted, very nervous in situations? Did you have any outward signs that you were not comfortable? What did you do to help? What are you doing to help? And what are your goals? What do you see yourself doing with it? Do you want to make videos? Do you want to be a movie star, but you're not, or a TV star, and you're not really good at talking to people? You know, let me know in the comments. Talk to me about it, because talking really helps with this stuff. Talking in front of the camera has been one of the best things for me, honestly. So now I can go out in a crowd and actually talk to people. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to go out to crowds, especially at car shows, because I still love car shows, and I'm going to talk to people because it's fun.